Election day is less than 3 months away, and Democratic leaders are addressing some important issues, particularly those that have voters questioning if their votes are secure and if they will be counted.
Misinformation and disinformation, interference from abroad, malfeasance at the local level, frankly, policies that are working to count voters out rather than count voters in, a structural, systemic, and many times racist way.
The Democratic National Convention and Business Forward put together this roundtable discussion entitled Protecting the Integrity of the Election. The panelists, which included public officials, Joe Biden's campaign team, and nonprofit groups, addressed some of the concerns and solutions when it comes to casting ballots, especially in this time of the COVID-19 pandemic. While President Donald Trump had attempted to slash and restructure the U.S. Postal Service, USPS has assured that any changes that will be made will not happen until after the November 3rd presidential election.
What we don't need, unfortunately, is a repeat of what we saw in primary after primary, where people literally risk their health just to cast a vote. Vote by mail is the lane that we need to run in, and that's why we cannot allow this administration to undermine the Postal Service in a way that it's clearly trying to drive the Postal Service to its knees.
Voter advocates and officials said the best way to ensure mail-in ballots are counted is for voters to drop them off at drop boxes or local registrars. In states that have early in-person voting, they said voters should turn out early to avoid the long lines and possible glitches. While California will primarily be vote by mail, officials are exploring the possibility of opening polling centers at sports stadiums.
Everything we can to make sure that voting this year is smooth, safe, and a secure process. Work is integrated into every element of the campaign. It's imbued into the campaign's core messaging, our engagement strategies, our organizing strategies. We're doing everything we can to make sure that voting this year is smooth, safe, and a secure process.
For states that will have in-person votes, Martin encourages voters to also consider volunteering or working as poll watchers, acting as one more line of defense to ensure that votes and the process itself stay safe and secure. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.
I'm not actually sure. Do you know Steve would be the one who knows about that?
Club, one day only. Yeah. And then I think tomorrow just like emergency and all the other vote centers.
We should put this like.